talking about Star Wars. It's like a madness, a Star Wars madness. Around the Christmas season, when the season is supposed to be about Christ, they release a movie that is not even about Christ. And there's some Christians that are actually going to see this movie. Does a study need to be made to tell Christians that this movie is not of God at all? That it actually promotes New Age or New World Order principles in the movie itself? Witchcraft, necromancy, enchantment? And in this video, we're going to talk about Star Wars. We're going to expose it because that's what it's for. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 11, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. So what is this? We've got people with light swords. We've got people that can control things and cause pain without touching someone. Very interesting. Deuteronomy chapter 18 verses 10 to 12. It says, there shall not be found amongst you any that causes his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or to do divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer, for all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord. And because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee. So God is really serious about this stuff. What do you see in Star Wars? You see all sorts of evil. Evil between the dark side and I guess the light side, if there's such. And they always say, the Force is with you. What about the Lord be with you? These are the things we're going to be looking in depth. We have about 8 points I'd like to make. And after this video, I know that you will see that Star Wars is nothing but a New Age movement and a New World Order plot to desensitize you for the things that are coming in the future. Please watch.
Now, you've created this galaxy that has been embraced and, you know, reverberating through generations of fans. What does that mean to you?
Well, it started off wanting to do a film for young people that had...
George Lucas glorifies not God, but the Force. Daniel 11:38 warns, the God of the Antichrist will be the God of forces. The notion of an impersonal force being God serves to deny God's relationship with man. The notion of the Force is a central theme in Luciferianism and the central theme behind the secularist worldview. Okay, so what's this Force thing talking about? Let's take a look. Point number one, may the Force be with you, is a variation on the Christian phrase, may the Lord be with you. Occultists take pleasure in removing any reference to Jesus, and even greater pleasure when the people can be deceived to participate in abominations. This is exactly what happens with the word Lord and when you change it from Lord to Force. In the occult or in witchcraft, may the Force be with you is very common as a greeting. And of course, you know, Star Wars today, they use this very phrase or greeting from witchcraft. Now, a Christian author, Pastor David J. Meyer, once a practicing witch, explains the true meaning of may the Force be with you. He wrote, the real witches have sabbats and esbats and meet as a coven. They greet each other by saying, blessed be, and when they part, they say, the Force be with you. Both sides of this force are Satan. It is not a good side of the Force that overcomes the bad side of the Force, but rather it's the blood of Jesus that destroys both sides of the satanic force. Humans are all children of God. Jesus taught that we are all of equal value, but Star Wars teaches the ancient and Nazi-like notion of superior blood. The New Age notion of divinely born masters or saviors reject Christ, but still are able to save the universe as a key Star Wars message. The concept of lower and higher level human forms of life is a key part of the New World Order religion. In Star Wars, both Obi-Wan Kenobi and Yoda appear as familiar spirits to instruct and advise Luke Skywalker. This Babylonian necromancer practice is prohibited in the Bible. The Star Wars concept of eternal life matches not Christianity, but the occult theosophy. Theosophy teaches deceased masters can communicate after their death to spiritually awaken individuals. Contact with a supernatural agency is viewed by Christians, Jews, and Muslims as contact with a fallen angel or a demon. Abrahamic religions teach that supernatural contact appears as a deceased loved one is a demon who has assumed the identity of a deceased person to fool the victim for evil purposes. Divination and all forms of witchcraft are explicitly forbidden in the Bible. Leviticus 19:26, we learn, it says, you shall not eat anything with the blood, nor shall you practice divination or soothsaying. Deuteronomy provides serious warnings not to promote the witchcraft religion of the Antichrist. Moving items with calling upon demonic force powers, like the Force, divination, consulting with familiar spirits, or forcing our will on others, such as using mind control to make people say and do things, like Obi-Wan Kenobi. Obi-Wan Kenobi is one example of a good Jedi that violates all these biblical principles. God is perfect and absolute. Obi-Wan teaches Anakin the concept that absolutes belong on the evil side when he says only a Sith deals in absolutes. As Christians, we understand that Jesus was without sin and God is absolutely good. By teaching Anakin absolutes belong on the evil side, Obi-Wan is teaching a Luciferian concept that the God of Moses, absolutely good, is evil. The good God in the Luciferian belief system participates in evil justified by situational ethics.
I am the God! I am the God!
Luciferians believe in a God of power, as did the Egyptian pharaohs. The more power a person accumulates in this life will dictate how much status they will have in the next life. In Star Wars, the viable eternal power to acquire is force or white magic power. Moving objects is explained in Star Wars by learning how to communicate with a living presence in blood. This presence in Christianity is a demon, but in Star Wars it is called midichlorians. Midichlorians in Star Wars are in all people, but an elite bloodline exists which has higher concentrations of midichlorians, Luke Skywalker. The bloodline purity concept was a major tenet of Nazi Germany in the last century, and it is a Luciferian teaching. The entire master and student concept in Star Wars is troubling. The Jedi teach obedience to the master, one of the most important rules. Jesus is our savior and spiritual master. Star Wars teaches human beings, Jedi, should be and are spiritual masters for other human beings. Jesus provides very clear guidance on the subject of master and student. No one can serve two masters. No servant can serve two masters, for either he will hate one and love the other, or else he will hold on to one and despise the other. He cannot serve God and mammon. And that's taken from Luke 16:13. The names in Star Wars almost always have a New World Order religious significance. For example, Master Qui-Gon Jinn means Master of Life, Energy, Spirits. Qi is pronounced Qi or Qi, is the Eastern art of Qi or Qi, life energy. Jinn is a genie or Jinn, which is a Middle Eastern spirit or demon which has supernatural influence over people. Qui-Gon Jinn teaches Anakin to trust his instincts and rely on his subconscious urges instead of trusting in God. Qui-Gon's student Obi-Wan would teach Luke Skywalker to trust his feelings. To have faith in our ability to accomplish a difficult task is a good thing, but Star Wars twists this because the students are told to have faith in a supernatural force that is not God to accomplish the difficult task. The Word of God is what should guide our actions, not a supernatural force possessing us. Luciferianism teaches follow your feeling or your heart. Christianity warns us our heart can mislead us and we are to always follow God's law. Alright, let's talk about Yoda. Some of the name meaning require an extensive knowledge of occult religions, especially the ancient Egyptian mystery religions. For example, Yoda is a hidden master in the religion of Freemasonry. Freemasonry claims a direct lineage from ancient Egypt and even the legendary people of Atlantis. Freemasonry is so secretive that official spokespeople often deny it is a religion. Upper-level Freemasons have specific esoteric Knights Templars rituals for illuminated members. In the Freemason York Rite, the Knights Templars is the final order and Knights Templars rituals exist outside the York Rite branch of Freemasonry. The Knights Templars had an intermediary with Lucifer called Jota or Yota. Freemasonry teaches the creature was small, had pointed ears, and was the ultimate teacher. Oh, this is one of the most exciting parts of this video. Let's talk about the word Jedi. The word Jedi has a dark side and it comes from Jedi, which is spelled D-J-E-D-I. Jedi is the name of the magician who the Pharaoh Khufu consulted to help build the Great Pyramid of Giza. Khufu, also known as Cheops, reigned from around 2589 to 2566 BC. Khufu was the second pharaoh of the Fourth Dynasty. Khufu was succeeded by his son Djefre, or Ra-Djefre. The name Jedi is also a name for powerful magicians in the service of the power elite of Pharaoh. In Star Wars, the Jedi also are powerful magicians in the service of a power elite. The Jedi sorcerers in ancient Egypt were the magicians that tried to defeat Moses and Aaron, who demanded the Pharaoh, Ramses II, to free the Hebrews. The Jedi failed to defeat Moses, but did possess Jedi-like powers. Very interesting. Wow, and it goes back. And Moses and Aaron went unto Pharaoh, and they did as the Lord commanded them. And Aaron cast his rod before Pharaoh and before his servants, and it became a serpent. The Pharaoh also called the wise men and the sorcerers the Jedi, now the magicians of Egypt. They also did in like manner with their enchantments, for they cast down every man his rod, and they became serpents. But Aaron's rod swallowed up the rods. This is taken from Exodus chapter 7, verses 10 to 12. God instructed Moses and Aaron to use their staff to battle the Jedi because the Jedi staff was their most powerful magic trick. The Pharaoh and the Jedi were falsely confident their multiple serpents would be victorious against a single serpent. In Star Wars, the Jedi fight with a more modern staff called a lightsaber powered by a gem. Multiple occult religions teach that gems can possess tremendous power. The Jedi lightsaber makes his occult teaching a household practice as children pretend to power up their lightsabers using rocks. Now let's talk about Anakin. Anakin is presented as a false Christ born from a virgin, possessing special powers from birth and proclaimed as the savior. Luke Skywalker is presented as the true savior. Lucifer, the god of the New World Order religion, once was known as a Skywalker. or a fallen angel cast from heaven appearing in the sky as light. Wow. In Luke 10:18, we learn, and he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. In Isaiah 14:12, we learn, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? Guys, you have to see this. And if you choose not to, that's really your problem. Star Wars is nothing for Christians to be watching. You may be high up. You may be a preacher. You may not be a preacher. You may be a layman. You may, whatever you may be, it doesn't matter. Just because you're that doesn't mean you could do anything you want. Star Wars is not meant for Christians. It teaches New World and New Age movement principles, witchcraft, necromancy, enchantments, and so on and so forth. And it actually tries to bring down Jesus Christ and uplift the adversary. Star Wars is not for you. And any movie that comes out in a movie theater is not for any Christian to watch, because it's just another ploy for the enemy to use to confuse you and your children to think that this is socially for Christians acceptable.